Hey everyone, it's me, Arthur Cade. I remember interviewing you, George Takei, for your documentary, and you were telling me Allegiant San Diego. I hope I can get this to Broadway. Guess what? We're talking on Broadway and Allegiant is here. How crazy is that?
I thought then, back then in San Diego, it would happen immediately, imminently. But there was that interregnum of 3 years, and we used those 3 years to polish and tweak and make it even better. And here we are in this beautiful Longacre Theater in technical rehearsals. I can't tell you how thrilled I am.
This is such a personal story for you, and a story, and I've talked to you about this, that needs to be told. Talk to me about now being able to tell it to the multitude in New York.
We are absolutely so thrilled and excited to be able to tell it to not just New York, but people are coming in from all over to see this. It's an important story, and we tell it with music and with joy and with engaging production numbers, because, you know, it took a lot of resilience on the part of the Japanese Americans to survive in those camps. And a measure of that resilience is the ability to find joy and romance and love. And we have two love stories, siblings. One, a young man who is very, very optimistic about his own life, despite the circumstances, who falls in love with a white army nurse, a forbidden love, a dangerous love behind barbed wires. The sister falls in love with a young law student who knows that this is unconstitutional. And he decides he's going to be a resistor. And she joins him and becomes a part of the resistance. So that breaks up the family. But ultimately, the basic core love brings them together. It's a Broadway musical told with joy and love and with great drama.
Speaking of drama, I've got to ask you, because you're such a great opinion base, we're seeing some drama in politics right now. I need to know George Takei's thoughts on Donald Trump.
Donald Trump, of course. You know, I did the Apprentice, yep. So I've worked with him. He's a bigger-than-life guy. He really is almost a cartoon. I don't think he is really up on issues, substance in politics. But it's a time when our politics is very, very, well, I call the Congress a wacko institution. And I think the voters are really frustrated with the politicians that we have. So someone like Donald, who's a television figure and very much loved by the audience, can soar in the ratings. But ultimately, the proof of the pudding has to show. And I don't think there's too much pudding there.